Hello, this is Jody Rowe and Diane Smith. Today we will be exploring Nearpod's self-paced lesson feature. Nearpod is a tool that can be used to engage students no matter where they are. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell to enable notifications for our channel by clicking our logo during the video. Also, leave us a comment or check out our related videos by clicking the pop-up cards in the upper right corner. Here's how to get started with Nearpod's self-paced lesson feature. So today we're going to be talking about student-paced lessons in Nearpod. Here is what, when you log into Nearpod, your home page or home screen will look like. And you're going to have options here. Your library will be the first thing that shows up, which is anything that you create or add from their library. Later, school libraries and district libraries can be created. So anything that you have added to your collection will show up here on this page. The lesson that we're going to use today actually came from the Nearpod library. Over to the left is, you can click on that and search the resources. There are tons of resources there, and you can sort them by subject area and age and grade, and it's a very helpful resource, so I would encourage you to check that out. But today we are going to use the social emotional temperature check for elementary school lesson that was created by Nearpod. And anytime you go to click on a lesson, you are going to be given the option of live participation or student paced. Live participation is going to allow the teacher to control the pace of the lesson. Students are locked into their screen and cannot go ahead or go back without the teacher doing so, and they can only go to any websites or activities that are linked or included in the presentation. The student-paced version allows the students to go on their own and work, but they still will be asked questions and can do some of the activities. And this is going to be very helpful when it comes to the asynchronous learning that we're going to have going on sometimes right now. So when I go to click, I'm going to choose student-paced, and it is going to provide me with a code. And there's a couple of things here. This code can be shared a variety of ways. You could post it to Google Classroom from here. You can obtain a link, you could email, there's many options here for that. There is also an area to view progress when you click here, which as students start answering, that's where you would be able to see who has done what and how far along they are. Also here is where there's going to be an option to require student submissions, and you can turn that on or off. There are some settings that are going to be important here that we're going to go over a little later in the presentation. But if you want to make sure that they are answering any questions you can include, I would make sure that that is on. But there is a way that we can adjust that for the future as well. These codes last for up to 30 days. If you are going to use the code in different classes, just know that all classes would mix together if you use one code. If you want to be able to do the lesson and separate it by class, you may want to start the student-paced lesson multiple times together, different codes, so that they're not mixed together. That just is probably a personal preference. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to go over and pretend that I am a student and see what that looks like from that side while I am joining with the code that is supplied. Now I am over as a student, and on the previous screen when I was being the teacher, there was a website that students will use to go to that will be shared with them, and they will enter their code, and they are not case sensitive, which is actually very helpful, so that will not have a bearing on whether they can join correctly or not. So as I've typed my code in, the next thing it is going to ask for my name. For right now, since I'm going to pretend to be a student, I'm just going to put student one. And I'm going to join the lesson. Now, because this is student-paced, again, I can go forward and backward at my leisure. One thing that can be turned on in settings, which again, we will go over shortly, there is a option to have notes on here, and the students can choose to save to their Google Drive, and they can actually take notes throughout the lesson, which is a very helpful option to have. So we will go over where that is towards the end here, but I'm going to continue on. Obviously, if I was a student, hopefully I would be taking a little bit longer here and reading these slides, but this is where we will get to some of the activities that are included here. So I'm being asked how I'm feeling and to circle that character. So again, there are options in Nearpod where students can draw, they could use text if need be, eraser, I can choose the color that I want to use. So I'm going to go ahead and choose green. I'm circling this. I've got that part done. I'm going to submit and I'm going to continue on. The next one is a poll. So again, it's going to ask me a question. And because I chose that the options to answer are required, I will need to do that. So again, I'm going to choose that I picked happy. I'm going to submit and continue on. This slide's going to ask me to draw and or type. So I'm feeling I need to circle one. So again, I could use the color and I chose happy. And then I'm feeling that way because, so again, students could write or type. I just ate dinner, so I'm going to write that I'm happy because I had dinner. And again, they could use text if they wanted, but I'm going to submit. And then that is the end. And again, because it's self-paced, I could go forward or backward where I needed to. Now I'm going to go back to the teacher side so that you can see what happens when we go from there. So now we're back on the teacher side again, and I'm going to go back to the lesson and click student paste. And then you can see here, I have this one that I have created. So I'm going to click the highlight that option. Again, this is where if you had started multiple ones, they would show up here. And I'm going to click view progress. I also filled this out as a second student just so you could see what multiple answers would show up as. So here it shows me who's done it. And there is an option down here to show or not show student names. So as we go through, I'll show you how that's kind of affected there. And then we keep going. So we go through these slides that they went through, but specifically we're going to get to where some of the answers were. So if the names are hidden, this is what it would look like. But if it's just me looking at it, I would probably do it this way. So I see what student one chose and what student two chose. I can continue on to the poll and I will see what each student chose. Plus I get a option to show me a graph of the choices from the class as a whole, plus individually. I can continue on, and this has some of the where they drew the background images and things, wrote why they felt that way. And sometimes these take a minute to pop up, so patience is always key here. But you could see where student one said happy because of dinner. This student typed in that friends not getting along, and then that's the end. So that is how I can see what each student has answered and their progress. You can also always go to the area on the left side that says My Reports and see any lessons you have done there, but they will all show up there. So I would suggest if you're just doing a specific one to go to that one. The last thing we were going to talk about are some of these settings. And up to the top right, if you haven't really used this, this may be blank, but you're going to click on this area where you might have a picture or emoji eventually or your face and click Lesson Settings. Now, we're going to focus more on the ones that apply to student-paced learning. I mentioned the notes option that may or may not be on or off when you start. So if you do want them to be able to have that option, this would need to be on. So I would definitely check that first. You also can have the option to show quiz and multiple choice question results when it is student-paced. So they would know if the answer was correct or not immediately, or you could have it off where they could not do that. Also, I'm going to go down the bottom and come back up to this one. This one was asked when we started the lesson, but this I can turn it on for everything that students would have to be required to answer any of these open-ended quiz, poll questions, and draw it activities so that they cannot skip through without it. But you always can enable or disable this when you start your lesson. Last, there is a collaborative board that's very similar to Padlet that's an option to add in from Nearpod. But when it is student-paced, if this is not on, it will not work. So for that to work, you would need to turn this on. And then students would be able to post and collaborate, and they'll see their posts immediately as they go in and out of the lesson. But that has to be on, and that is typically not on when you start. So hopefully this has helped you with the student-paced lesson option in Nearpod.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, or reply to one of our other videos or share the playlist below. Subscribe to our channel and enable notifications so that you don't miss out on the next episode. Don't forget to check out our other resources and see what else is going on in Horry County Schools. Be sure to follow at Dear Disses on social media or contact us via email or our blog.